My Dida passed away recently. He died in my arms as I was saying goodbye to him. This is his story. Ante Separovich, my grandfather, was always called Dida. He was born on the 22nd of May 1927 in a quiet village called Blato on the island of Korčula, a three-hour ferry ride from the Croatian coast. Dida was born 9 years after World War I had finished, but the country was still rebuilding from the ravages of war. It was hard for Dida growing up. His family was poor and he was taken from school at an early age to work on the family farm. Olive oil, wine, and fig trees were the main products of the region, and much of the town's economy was based around the production of these agricultural products. Whilst Dida became a hard-working labourer, he could barely read or write. He longed to go to school and have an education like many other children. In April 1941, during World War II, the Kingdom of Yugoslavia was invaded by the Axis powers, the Germans and Italians. The country became a Nazi puppet state and was ruled by the Ustashi regime for 4 years. They pursued a policy of racial and ethnic persecution against the Jewish, Gypsy and Serbian population, or anyone that defied them. When Dida was 14, Korčula was invaded by the Germans and Italians. Dida fought against them to protect his home and served with the local partisans. The partisans were the native guerrillas fighting against the invading enemy. They soon became a widespread anti-fascist communist-led movement. Dida was a messenger boy. His lack of literacy meant he couldn't read the instructions if he was captured. So he ran for his life through bullets, dead bodies and military camps and up into the mountains for the partisans, taking secret handwritten messages. Dida was captured by German soldiers twice. Once he was spared because a German soldier felt that he was too young to die. The second time, Dida was being taken to a concentration camp in Germany when American planes bombed the troops below and he escaped, making his way back to Croatia. His older brother, who was also a partisan, was beheaded at the age of 19. By 1945, against all odds, the partisans expelled the enemy forces. This is often regarded as the most effective resistance in occupied Europe. The partisan leader, Josip Borj Tito, became the Prime Minister and then President of the Federal People's Republic of Yugoslavia. While Tito's leadership has been criticized as authoritarian, verging on dictatorship, he maintained peaceful coexistence and economic prosperity. From Dida's perspective, Tito was a hero and saved the country. Dida always kept a picture of Tito on his mantelpiece. After World War II, Dida met his wife, who had their first child in 1953. My Dida wanted a better life and future for his family. He did not want his children to ever experience war and hardship. So at 28 years of age, he packed up his belongings and travelled by ship for 6 weeks to reach Australia in 1955. His cousin in Broken Hill was his guarantor and vouched that he was a good worker before his immigration papers were signed. Dida worked in Broken Hill as a miner for 18 hard years, working underground to mine silver, lead, zinc and coal. Whilst he came from work black and dirty, his children went to school immaculately dressed and clean. Dida did not have the language nor the education to help his children with their schooling, so he bought the Encyclopedia Britannica to support them. He paid it off in monthly installments for the next 2 years. This was a big investment and showed the value he placed on providing education and opportunity for his family. When Broken Hill declined in the mid-70s, Dida followed his two daughters, who were accepted with academic merit to Sydney University. He was extremely proud of his children's success and felt validated for his great life choice to migrate to Australia. My Dida loved Australia. He called it his home. It was a young, peaceful country with a democratic government where people were treated fairly and equally. Dida said he never experienced any prejudice and was welcomed and helped by his neighbours and local community. His children were raised with his hard work ethic, generous values, an appreciation for education, and a deep love for this sunburnt country. These values have been passed down from generation to generation. He is one of the reasons I became a teacher and the person I am today. It shows me that whilst time and place may change, the value of education, family, and opportunity remains the same. My Dida was a man who did not say much, who persevered through war and hardship, who had the courage to start a new life in an unknown land, and who valued peace, family, and education above all else. This is his story, and this is my goodbye.